to second and 10 from the 25. So the false start will back them up 5.
False start, offense.
So that'll back them up 5. So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He lost 2 there. And it's third down. Third and long. It's Newton. That's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on. They just play better and better.
Desperation time. Newton, third goal. And he's going to be taken down. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really doesn't matter. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Los Angeles. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right? And sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and it translated that into a win.
It did indeed. They protected the home field. And now the final stages. He's letting it fly. This is caught inside the 15. And he makes it all the way down to the 13-yard line.
Tell the truth, partner. You didn't think he was coming down with that one, did you? Come on, tell me the truth.
No, I did. I'll tell you what, though. A one-handed grab of that length. Talk about giving your team a little juice.
Oh, big time. I mean, everyone's going to be excited about that one, whether you're on the field or not. Permeates his way to
the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Saquon Barkley from 13 yards out. And the Rams add on to their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start running widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. To try to end the PAT. Once with the extra point, and it is 28-0. Lutz now to kick this one away. Here comes Shields. Taking it out past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. It'd be just one last drive here for five.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge. And someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Just get out of here and we'll do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue
to move forward.
Yeah, I just want to put this one behind them. Here's Newton. Looking mellow and that's incomplete. Giovanni Bernard, the intended receiver out of the backfield. That'll bring up second down.
So they look like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
Second and 10, Newton again. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Didn't have the receiver open down to him as it turned out. Couldn't find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Now a play fake and it's Newton. And Jeffrey's got it. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As he'll stop him with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. Seconds showing on the clock. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. To the air again, Newton. Oh, Newton complete. It's Reed. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. As the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. The Raiders on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. Throwing again. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they held them in check on the scoreboard. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. So good field position for the Rams as they come up 1st and 10. Just 3 seconds left. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
Here's Michael Vick. And going deep for Hill. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And that will light a flash to this ballgame. So Giants are able to complete what so often seems to be elusive, a shutout in the NFL. And maybe what's fitting is they ended the game on the field, that defensive unit on the field with an exclamation mark.
And probably felt like they could go another 60 minutes without anyone putting points on the board against them. That's the confidence you gain throughout when you're pitching a shutout. And they're going to leave the stadium feeling like they're all 10 feet tall.
So that'll do it from here for Charles Davis and the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gunn. You've been watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com/Madden. From Minneapolis, so long, everybody.